كتاب الله كتاب الله
كتاب الله
كتاب الله
كتاب الله
First, this is the comprehensive message of the Quran. And this is brought to you through Surah Al-Asr. Very small but very comprehensive Surah of the Quran. And just recite, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal-Asri innal insana lafi khusr. إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Translation by the blessed of time. Indeed, man is in a state of loss, except those who believe and perform the righteous acts and enjoin one another the truth and enjoin one another the endurance. You know, the reasonable recommended attitude of any human being towards a new statement cannot be other than this, that first he evaluates the statement. If it appears to him a true, he declares, yes, it's true, believes in it, and that is the first step. Acts according to that, this is the second step, and enjoins others to accept that truth and act accordingly. And if he faces some problem in the course, he should face himself with endurance and enjoin the same to others as well. This is the reasonable attitude. And there can be many, many unreasonable attitudes. For example, not to consider, be indifferent. This is unreasonable attitude. Then it appears to him a truth, but he avoids to declare it. This is called kufr. It is the opposite of iman. Then an unreasonable attitude can be, he believes, declares, but doesn't act accordingly. And there can be another unreasonable attitude, that he starts acting upon it, starts working and acting accordingly, but he faces problem. He faces some threat, maybe a life of threat, a threat of a loss of property, or he faces an abuse and he thinks he can't bear them and just steps back. These are all unreasonable attitudes, and there can be dozens of unreasonable attitudes. But the most reasonable and recommended attitude is that he evaluates. If he appears to him correct, believes in it, declares openly it's correct, it's the truth, acts accordingly, propagates that message, endures, and he is steadfast in He steadfast himself and he enjoins others too to be steadfast. Now this is the complete message of the Quran. You will find this message in many other places of the Quran in different ways. Quran declares, وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. We have presented in this Quran our revelations, our ayat, our signs in different ways, in diverse ways. So terminologies would change, expressions would change, but the message would be the same. Here we have some examples. The first example is at page 2 of your text, ayah 177 of the second surah of the Quran. In this ayah, you will find the same message. The terminology has been changed, expression is different, but it's the same message in a different way. So, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ليس البراء أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. It's not the only virtue. You know, the story behind was that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to act upon the known commandments of Torah until there was a change from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was from the sons of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, and the center for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala built by Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam was Al-Kaaba Tul Musharrafa in Makkah. Yet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew that in Torah, Allah Almighty has asked to face Jerusalem, the Masjid al-Aqsa. So, as long as it was possible for him to face the two houses of Allah, that is, to offer his prayer in Haram, he used to stand on the southern side of Kaaba, so that he simultaneously faces the Kaaba as well as Jerusalem. But when it was not possible for him to pray there, and he had to move his center to Darul Arqam, radiallahu anhu, then it was not possible, and he, according to Allah's command, was facing Jerusalem, not the Kaaba. And so did it continue when he moved to Medina, because Medina is in north of Makkah and in further north is Jerusalem. So when he was facing Jerusalem, he was backing Makkah, the Kaabatul Musharrafa, Allah's house, which he didn't like. But no matter what you like and what you don't, Allah's command is Allah's command. This is what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnat was. So despite his display, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to face Jerusalem and expected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will be kind enough to change the direction from Jerusalem to Kaaba. And he received that command after about 18 months of his stay at Medina. Now, the Yahud living in Medina, they were angry, and they had to be. They assumed that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his follower, their follower. And the Muslims too are their followers, because they are facing their direction. But when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was directed to turn his face from Jerusalem to Makkah, it was evident. It was manifest that this is a new Ummah being formed around a new direction of Qibla. So they started torturing the Muslim in different ways. Yes, you lost all your prayers for 18 months we have been praying. The answer was given. No. The real direction is what Allah asks you to face. If Allah asks you to face the east, you have to face the east. If Allah asks you to face the west, you have to face the west. Similarly, north, east, whatever. Allah is everywhere. And then the concluding ayah was this. But in that conclusion, it was told that of course it's very important to face the right direction of Qibla. But remember, Islam is not only the right direction of Qibla. Right direction of Qibla is just a part of Islam. You know, out of many commands, one of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to pray five times. And prayer has got many arkan and many prerequisites. And one of the prerequisites is to face the Qibla. It's not the whole Islam. So from here we start. لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَنْ تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ. It's not the only virtue that you turn your faces towards the east and the west. وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ. But the virtue is, in brackets, of those مَنْ آمَنَ, who believe بِاللَّهِ, in Allah, wal yawm al akhir, and the last day, wal malaika, and the angels, wal kitabi wan nabiyyin, and the books and the prophets. You know, the five most important constituents of iman have been described. Yet this is not the whole story. You know, what you are supposed to believe is even beyond that, but five most important have been discussed. And then وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ, and they spend wealth despite its love. ذَوِ الْقُرْبَىٰ, on relatives. وَالْيَتَامَىٰ, and the orphans. وَالْمَسَاكِينَ, and the helpless ones. وَبْنَ السَّبِيلِ, and the travelers. وَالسَّائِلِينَ, including those who ask for, you know, sa'il, one who asks for a beggar. وَفِي الرِّقَابِ, and also to ransom the neck, that is, to get the neck of a person released from slavery or having debt. وَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَى الزَّكَاةَ, moreover, they establish prayer. وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ, and pay zakat, regular charity, you know. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِأَحْدِهِمْ إِلَىٰ أَحَدٍ, and also fulfill their promise whenever they make a commitment. وَالصَّابِرِينَ, especially to mention are those firm fil basai wad darai wa hin al bas, in hunger, adversity, and at a time of war. Ulai kal lazina sadaqu, such are the truthful ones. Wa ulai humul muttaqun, and such are the God fearing ones too. You know, the three terminologies of the Quran have been described and defined in one ayah. Number one, the birr, al-birru, the virtue. You know, when you use the word virtue, what does the Quran mean by that? This is the description. Then, the word sidq, truth. Who are the truthful ones? Truth of word, truth of character. That form the whole truth. And then another important terminology, taqwa. No different translations. Some people translate taqwa as God fear. Muttaqeen, God fearing. Others translate the pious ones. Some others translate those who avoid the sins. But the Quranic definition, the comprehensive definition of the word taqwa is here. Then, you see the beauty of this ayah? This ayah al-Mubarakah tells us that bir includes iman too. Not only that, which means two persons doing the same thing, performing the same act, one out of iman, the other without iman, are not, both are not virtuous. If a true believer performs an act, he will be rewarded. But if a kafir does the same thing, he will not be rewarded. He will not be considered virtuous in Allah's eyes. Why? There can be big question mark. Is Allah wise? Yes, he is. Why someone is doing some charity work since he doesn't believe in Allah? Why he is doing? He wants to be well known as a charitable man? Yes, he has been well known. There is a beautiful hadith in this connection. The Prophet ﷺ said on the day of judgment, three people will be brought. One of them shaheed, the other an alim, another a sakhi, a very generous man. Generous man will be asked, I gave you this, 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 what did you do for me? He will say, oh my Lord, I did a lot of charity work to please you. Allah Almighty will say, you are lying. You did all that just to be known to be a generous man. And that has been, you have nothing here.